Users of English are often concerned about issues of correctness and authority. Who gets to decide what's right and what's wrong? I'm sitting in Oxford University Press, home of the Oxford English Dictionary, a classic guardian of the English language, seen as an authority throughout the world. It's partly because of that, of course, that people were so shocked when Oxford Dictionaries recently announced that its word of the year was not a word at all, but an emoji. But this aspect of a dictionary is really exactly how a dictionary works, monitoring the way that people use language and recording it and responding to it, rather than dictating how people should use language. So to pick an emoji as the word of the year is simply to respond to the way that people are increasingly using these. And this is a feature of electronic language today, the way that it resembles casual conversation more than formal written prose. And so we try to find ways to communicate our emotions in ways that are quick and succinct, using initially emoticons, slightly old-fashioned forms of based upon punctuation that allows us to communicate how we feel. That developed into the use of acronyms like LOL. And now we have emojis that help us to communicate those emotions in the way that we might using hand gestures and facial expressions and tone of voice in a face-to-face interaction. So one of the things that people have often asked me after this announcement is, what does this mean for the future of the English language? What would you as a professor of English at Oxford University make of it if a student submitted an essay to you written entirely in emoji? But the answer to that, of course, is simple. I'd simply ask them to do it again in standard English.